You are welcome to Emacom TV. In today's episode, we'll be looking at Onnoghen to federal government. You have no powers to try me as CCT, that is Code of Conduct Tribunal. The man here in question, Onnoghen, he is currently the Chief Justice of Nigeria, that is CJN. He has been in the storm for some time now on issues bordering around assets declaration. And you know that before you take office as a public officer, you have to declare your assets. So in declaring of his asset, he did not make a full disclosure of his assets. And so therefore, another independent NGO had to come out and blow the lid open that Onnoghen has, you know, some assets he has not declared. So he has been in a storm. Like I said, the federal government were seeking to prosecute him. They even charged him to CCT, that is Code of Conduct Tribunal. So we are going to look at what is happening here. He is now challenging the federal government that the federal government have no powers to try him at Code of Conduct Tribunal. Let's look at it. Declined to appear for trial as 89 lawyers rises to his defense. Tribunal shift arraignment till January 22nd. Order fresh service of charge. The Chief Justice of Nigeria, CJN Justice Walter Onnoghen, on Monday challenged the jurisdiction of the Code of Conduct Tribunal, CCT, sitting in Abuja to try him over his alleged failure to declare his assets. Now, this is the man here, this is Onnoghen, this is the Chief Justice of Nigeria. The CJN, who stole his planned arraignment following his refusal to appear before the Justice Danladi Umar's led three-panel tribunal, was, however, represented by a consortium of 89 lawyers that comprise of 46 senior advocates of Nigeria. Just imagine that. Just imagine the pomp and, you know, having this number of SAN, you know, accompanying you or representing you in court. Imagine the amount, imagine the cost of, you know, having this number of lawyer. So you can see here, we are talking about pomp, we're talking about glory here. The man here has, Onnoghen here has a very big backing behind him. That is why you can see he totally refused to appear. I'm not trying to side anyone. You know, I'm just trying to be apolitical in this issue. So, let's go on. You see, the legal team, which was led by a former president of the Nigerian Bar Association, NBA Chief Wole Olanipekun, son, and a former Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Chief Kanu Agabi, San told the tribunal that their appearance at the proceeding was in protest. Olanipekun told the tribunal that the CJN has already filed a motion dated January 14 to challenge the jurisdiction of the tribunal to hear the charges federal government leveled against him. My lord, we are not just challenging the jurisdiction. We are even challenging the jurisdiction of the tribunal to even sniff that charge. We have served the complainant stroke respondent Olanipekun submitted. Though the said motion was not moved, nevertheless, member of the team who spoke to Vanguard on condition of anonymity said the CJN will capitalize on federal government's failure to channel the petition against him, as well as the outcome of the investigation that was purportedly conducted on his asset declaration form by the Code of Conduct Bureau, CCB, to the National Judicial Council, NJC, before he rushed the case to the CCT. CJN is contending that the federal government's failure to abide by existing judicial precedent as encapsulated in the recent appeal court decision in Nganjiwa versus Federal Republic of Nigeria 2017 LPELR-43391 to the effect that any misconduct attached to the office of the function of the judicial officer must first be reported to and handled by the NJC, that is National Judicial Council, pursuant to the provisions of the laws. He argued that only after the NJC has pronounced against such judicial officer could prosecuting agencies of the federal government proceed to initiate a criminal proceedings. Consequently, placing reliance on a recent decision of CCT on a similar charge, federal government lodged against another justice of the Supreme Court, Sylvester Nguta, the CJN legal team maintained that federal government decision to sideline the agency stripped the tribunal of its jurisdiction to entertain the instant case. Meanwhile, after the charge, Mark CCT / ABJ / 01 / 19 was called up at exactly 10 a.m., Chairman of the Tribunal, Justice Umar, demanded to know why the CJN was not in court and if he was served with the charge. Responding, former Commissioner of Justice in Kano State, Alhaji Ali Umar, whom federal government engaged to head its five-man prosecution team, told the tribunal that the CJN was served through one of his personal assistants. He said, when we went to his house, he directed his personal assistant to collect the charge on his behalf. His personal assistant endorsed it, so he has been served. Olanipekun immediately countered the prosecution and challenged the competence of the service of criminal charge on anybody aside the defendant himself. He insisted that under Section 123 and 124 of the Administration of Justice, Criminal Justice Act, ACJA 2015, the charge ought to have been served on the CJN personally, except when there is an order for substituted service. Not swayed by Olanipekun's argument, federal government lawyer Omar insisted that the CJN could not file application to challenge the jurisdiction of the CCT in absentia. It is our position that there is no law that says that a defendant can refuse to appear before the court. He should be here to take his plea first before raising any application. He has been summoned to appear before a court of law. He should be here before he can register his protest. This is a quasi-criminal matter, and under Section 396 of the ACJA, no motion can be heard in the absence of defendant, the prosecution insisted. So I'm going to put a full link to this article in the video so that you can go and read the remaining of this. So you can see here that there's a legal battle going on, you know, for Onnoghen. You know, Onnoghen here has 89 lawyers, you know, that are supporting him, that are backing him up. He has a lot of, you know, big players behind him. That is why you can see him challenge the federal government that they have no powers. And actually, in reality, what the federal government, the blunder the federal government did here was that they should have, you know, reported him to National Judicial Council first. You know, so I don't know how they were advised. They were not well advised. They shouldn't have taken him to Code of Conduct Tribunal first, before, you know, or instead of taking him to Code of Tribunal CCT, that is Code of Conduct Tribunal, they should have reported him as enshrined in the Constitution to National Judicial Council. So to me, I don't know what's your thought on this. I don't know what's your comment. You can let me know below. Do you think that the federal government stand a chance of winning against, you know, Onnoghen at the long run? Or do you think Onnoghen is going to win this case, considering the fact that the federal government has already goofed? The federal government has already messed up. They shouldn't have gone to CCT. They should have gone to NJC, National Judicial Council. So let me know your thought below. And if this is the first time you are, you know, you are coming to my channel, you can hit the subscribe button below and click on the bell icon to get our latest update on video. You know, we bring up brainstorming news where we can brainstorm together and look at the Nigerian political landscape and look at solutions and issues, you know, that can be tackled. So I don't know, you can leave your subscription below, comment below if you like, if you let me know your thoughts. And also you can like the video if you like, click on the like button if you like the video, or click on the dislike button. Thank you very much.